Welcome back to DIY with KB. My name is Kiva and I teach people how to achieve the luxe look for less. In today's video, I'm giving you 15 items under $20 from IKEA that I love. Before we get into today's video, please don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and check me out on Instagram. Now let's get into it. The first product that I want to share with you today is this IKEA food storage container, which is $5.99 and it is massive. So everyone loves a beautiful pantry. It's something that I'm working on doing, and a lot of people rely on those OXO containers. But these are $5.99 as opposed to like $20, and they're not too narrow. They could fit a variety of things, and they do have the pouring spout at the top, and they do appear to be airtight, which is super exciting. So I'm gonna use these all throughout my pantry just to get things looking nice and clean and streamlined. Again, I reference the OXO because I feel like the tall OXO ones, they're always like really narrow for like spaghetti, and I'm like, what if I'm not eating spaghetti? What if I want to eat like penne or something else? Like, what do I do then? So I think this one is a little bit more versatile, and I think it will work in, you know, in any pantry. The next item I want to talk to you about is this ramekin, which is only $2.99. It is microwave safe and it is oven safe, and I absolutely love it. And you're like, Kiva, it's just a ramekin. You're right, it is just a ramekin, but I don't know about you, but I got sucked into like oatmeal TikTok over the span of quarantine. So I love making baked oatmeal now, and I had nothing to bake it in, and it just allows you to make like sweet treats or little treats for yourself and like a good portion size, which I really enjoy because sometimes it's like, wow, I don't need like, you know, a 10-foot cake. I just want, you know, a small cake, and this allows you to do it. It's super affordable. It runs through the dishwasher super easily, which I love. Next, we're talking about curtains. So curtains can be super duper expensive, right? And sometimes you just need to like not have the sun blinding you for a second. And IKEA has the best curtains. I recommend them to everyone, regardless of whether they have a $1 million budget or a $50 budget. So these are the Ritva curtains. They are $20 for a pair. So that is $10 per panel, which I think is amazing. And they are incredible. So I don't have a window that can accommodate these curtains because my windows are huge. So I tried to actually hang it up like on a painting, and then everything came crashing down, but know that I tried for you. But these are the curtain panels. They definitely filter some light. You can't see through them all together. They are not actually made of linen, but they do look like linen, and they're very high end. I think the best way to elevate them is with these associated clips, which are $2.99 for a 10 pack. You have the rings, and then it comes with the clips. There are so many different ways you can configure them, but it allows you to kind of pleat your curtains like this, which is what you see in high end homes all the time. And they are just a basic off-white. So farmhouse, bohemian, modern, really no matter what, these are going to totally work for you. And I believe that IKEA has a range of curtains and different lengths and different widths and stuff like that, and they're all relatively affordable, but this one is $20, so it works for this video, and I'm obsessed with them. And I was wrong, these clips are actually $4.99, not $2.99, but still, that's a great price. I like to get them with the black, and then you can also get the black curtain rod from IKEA. It just looks a lot more refined, and clips really look more refined to me. They do have the things in the back so you could stick the pole through. They also have the pockets. I do not like grommets. I think they just look a little, they don't look the way I want them to look. So this really elevates the curtains. And as long as you know how to elevate your curtains, you can get something cheap and make it work for you. This next item is a storage basket that I cannot pronounce. I'm not even gonna attempt, but I will put it up here. It is this storage basket, and I really love it because it is extremely malleable, right? So it's a nice, really relaxed piece that you can add to a space. I'd probably use something like this behind, next to a sofa for dog toys, or throw blankets, or throw pillows. I don't know, it's just really nice and relaxed, and it looks super high-end, especially because it's so woven, and it doesn't really hold a structure in the same way. It doesn't look like a typical storage basket. It looks more kind of like a decorative piece. I really love this. I think this could work predominantly in like bohemian and modern organic spaces, but I think you could pull this off anywhere. These are also really good in nurseries as well, because you don't have to worry about sharp edges or anything like that, because it does just fold in on itself. If you wanted to hold its shape a little bit more, all you have to do is just fold down the sides a little bit, and now it's a little bit more of a rigid box. And babe, just made the excellent point that this actually gets 5 stars on the IKEA website, which honestly, that's a feat. Like, this basket deserves just like a round of applause. But look at it, it's really nice and cute. I really enjoy it. You could also use it for some books. You could use this just about anywhere, and it looks great. The next item is something I'm obsessed with. I've been using these for a little while now, and I love them. These are the Scub shoe containers, and they come in a 4-pack for $7.49 in the white, and then it gets more expensive with the other colors, but I said, I'm not picky. I'll take the white. And basically what they are is they are shoe containers. Let's actually open one up right here in real time. And when I say real time, I'm gonna have to cut it off because it takes me forever to open things, so give me a second. Update, I wasn't able to get those open, but no worries. I already had a set open. So basically what it is a collapsible shoe container, and you open it, you just put your shoes in there. You can put really big shoes. These are a size 10, right? And there's still a lot of space in there. So I feel like you could actually put 2 pairs of shoes in there, but it's, you just put it together. Then you take the Velcro, you let it meet, and then you can actually see what shoes you have in here, and they stack on top of one another. And that's what I really love about these. You can actually see what the shoe is, because you know when you're trying to store your shoes and you just like throw them into a big container, but then you have to like rip apart everything to find what you're looking for. You can see everything here, and these are super affordable at the Container Store. For like one of these, it's like at least $10, something like that, because I went back and forth about getting them and I just couldn't justify it. But again, this is a 4-pack for $7.49 and you can't go wrong. And another good point in comparing this one to the one from the Container Store, so these ones stack on top of one another, but for the Container Store, sometimes if you get like the more affordable one, you actually have to unstack them to access them. The really expensive ones, you can flip them down, but no one has money to waste on like a shoe container. So these are amazing. I have them for all of my shoes now, and you can put them really easily in a closet. Honestly, right now they're under a desk and you can't see them, and I love that. The next item is this Lazy Susan, which is $14.99. So really funny story, let's be friends here. Every time I go anywhere, I try to buy a Lazy Susan. And my wife was like, what are you gonna do with that? Because when I'm at TJ Maxx or Marshall's, the Lazy Susans are literally like the size of this ramekin and there's nothing to do with it. And they're also $15. But this one is 15 inches in diameter. It's $15 and it can fit a ton of stuff. If you don't know what a Lazy Susan is, it just rotates, right? So this is really good for your pantry or when you have these large spaces. I don't necessarily love the color, but since I'm not putting any food directly on it, what I am going to do is I'm actually just gonna sand it a little bit and like paint it a color that works for my design style. You could also cover this in contact paper or just like cut out your grip paper to make sure all of your condiments and stuff stick to it really well. But for the price, you can't beat it, and it's nice and large. And it just makes it easier when you're organizing your pantry because you don't have to take everything out to access everything. You can just rotate it about, and it makes it really easy to actually do some cooking in the house, which I feel like is something that really holds us all back. Access to things, keeping them organized. This is gonna help us cook at home this year. So next we have the Ziploc bags of IKEA. This is a 30 pack for $3.99, I believe. And they're literally just like Ziploc bags. They are the exact same thing, but they're made by IKEA and they're so much cheaper. And these are the only ones we use now. They have the 4.5 liter, they have the 6 liter, they even have like the small little baggies. So they're really great. They're just more affordable. That's really the only reason why I'm putting them in here. And the quality is still there. So it's not like the ones you get from the Dollar Tree and then you look at them and then the seams just rip. These actually do stay together. They keep your food nice and airtight, which I absolutely love. Next, we have this iHardig 4-pack of seasoning containers. They are $4.99 and they hold 5 ounces of seasoning, which I think is great. So I splurged on these. They actually had like a different set, but they didn't have a black top. They had a silver top, which was even cheaper. But babe said, live a little, so I did. So I got the ones with the black top, and I'm really excited about these because they're really affordable. So I was able to get like 10 sets of these. You keep it, why do you need 10 sets of seasonings? I like seasoned food, okay? But I really like these because I'm gonna be able to label them on with my Cricut. You're gonna see that. There are gonna be tons of organization videos, so subscribe if you're not already subscribed. But they're nice and streamlined, super affordable, so I can actually do all of my seasoning. Something that always holds me back, again, is affordability. Because you go to places and it'll be like $20 for 4 of these, and I'm like, okay, like I have to choose which seasoning is most important to me and which one is worthy of the nice container. This way I can get everything really nice and streamlined, which I'm super excited about. And even if you don't want to label them, obviously they're see-through, so you can see what the seasoning is. And of course, one side, it has the place for the large pour out, a spoon can't fit in it, and then you have the shaker portion. But they're really nice and cute, and they're nice and thick, which I really like. I just feel like they hold a lot more seasoning than other things. Maybe it's an illusion by the shape, but I've fallen for it. So next we have this wonderful kitchen rug. So before I show it to you, I will say, in one video I was like, you know, the ugly kitchen rugs are not it, and I still agree with that. So not only is this not an ugly kitchen rug, but it is a kitchen rug that's only $1.99. It's called the Kledge rug. This is what it looks like. It's just like a nice and jute and twine sort of thing. It is It is $1.99 worth of material, I will say that. But it will capture all that stuff that falls when you're cooking or doing the dishes and all that good stuff. And you have something somewhat comfortable on your feet. I don't know, it's really nice and cute. What I'd probably use this for though, actually, is I cut it up, I put it in a frame and use this to create some DIY art because this is DIY with KB. And we love to make things, especially affordably. So you could do that entirely from IKEA, get one of those Ribba frames and kind of call it a day. But you can't beat the price on this. You could also use this as like an entry mat, like just actually inside the house. So you have like the really rough run for outside the house, and then inside the house you can, you know, have people put their shoes or something on this, get all of that dirt and grime off your floor, and you're good to go. I mention these in every single IKEA video, and I do it for good reason. These are the best pillows on the planet. When you're looking for throw pillows, these are the Fajajar 26 by 26 pillows. They are $10 a piece, and they are full of duck feathers. If you don't support that, I totally understand. They do have down alternative as well, but I love these pillows. You get the really nice and fluffy look that everyone loves and everyone needs. I hate having throw pillows that look good, but you can't actually use them. I've been laying on the couch, lounging about so much recently, doing work, and it's nice to have a pillow that I can actually use and not feel like so uncomfortable with. So these pillows are it. They have these ones for $10, 26 by 26. They have lumbar pillows, and they also have a 20 by 20. I use these with really expensive pillowcases. That's how much I stand behind the quality. Like over there, these pillowcases you see behind me are $200 a piece. Don't ask me why I did that, but I did put them with these pillows inserts, and I swear by them. The quality is there, and you're not gonna regret getting these. And people do ask me all the time, Kiva, where can I use these? You can use them anywhere you have throw pillows. On your bed, they're good. On your accent chairs, they're good. On your entry like bench, they're good. On your sofas, on your love seats, anywhere you have them, you can use these pillows. You don't, the pillows don't restrict you in terms of like what room they can go in. Sometimes people, if they really want a super fluffy pillow on their bed and they don't want to pay, you know, the $100 or $200 for a big lounge pillow, they just stuff actually a few of these into one massive pillowcase and they get the pillow that way. You have to make sure that you're using, though, a pillowcase that isn't sheer, right? Because you'll be able to see the lines between the pillows. But this is a really good hack if, you know, you're working with a smaller budget, but you really want a luxurious looking bed. And if you want more tips on how to craft a luxurious looking bed, click up right here. I have a whole video on how to make your bed look luxurious in a really affordable way. Next, we're talking about honestly the best thing I've ever purchased from IKEA, and once you see it, you're gonna be so disappointed. But I'm talking to you about these off-task bowls. Is that what they're called, honey? Off-task bowls. They are the best bowls in the world. So this is one of the bowls. It's 79 cents, and then this is a bigger bowl for $1.99. And these bowls are amazing. They are microwave safe. They are dishwasher safe. You can put them in your sink. You can put these bowls anywhere and they're not gonna die. Okay, and the reason why I love these bowls is that sometimes you just need everyday bowls. You just want everyday bowls, and then if someone drops them, you don't want to feel like you got to take out a second mortgage to buy new ones, because sometimes that happens. We all have those dishes that we only bring out when the queen comes over, but the queen never comes over, so they just sit in the cupboard. So these are everyday dishes and we love them. They wash super easily. The quality is there, and you know, you get two different styles of bowls. Sometimes I feel like I'm like, do I want to get the big bowl or the small bowl? Which one am I gonna splurge on? Well, since this one is 79 cents and this one was $1.99, I was able to get both, and I feel like I'm living on top of the world. But we love these bowls. I'm telling you, you can use them for anything. You can use them from salad, for cereal, for anything you want. I think that they only come in white, but honestly, they're so good. And I think they do have associated plates. I told you guys, we're moving away from like plastic. So we used to use like, I hate to admit this, we used to use like those plastic like Dorm Essential plates from Target, because the quality was also there for with them, not gonna lie. But we use these now. They're ceramic, a little bit better for you. And they're so good. So I thought that these were ceramic, but it turns out I am wrong. So
they're actually made of tempered glass.
They're made of tempered glass. Look at IKEA. That sophistication there. I don't even know if that makes it more sophisticated.
It just means like they can push the price down to get you an elegant and shiny look.
They really got us there, didn't they? They really did. We absolutely love these bowls. Honestly, the dog loves these bowls as well. He's like, I feel like he's always trying to get them to be his food bowl, but no, he has one that says I am dog, and we like that a lot. The last thing we have in today's video is this Live Bosch charging pad. And you might be saying, Kiva, why do you need this? So we are all on our phones all the time, and I hate that. I hate being on my phone. I really don't like technology. Like, Kiva, don't you? Aren't you a content creator? I am. I love interacting with you, but I don't love the act of being on my phone. And what I love about this is that I can just set my phone down on something, but I can still read it. I don't have to be like close to the cord or anything like that. I don't know. It really doesn't change my experience that much, but it still seems like it does in my head. And what you do is it's just like a really nice and sleek charging pad. You set your phone on it and your phone charges. And what I love about this charging pad is that it's black. I think it also comes in gray and white as well. I might have made that up though, but it kind of blends in with my decor, right? I hate the look of cords everywhere. I think it's so messy. I hate that I can only find like bright blue like chargers for my phone. Sometimes I just want something nice and sleek, and that's exactly what this is. You have to buy this and then a separate USB port and then like a separate like butt or like charging port. But I just use the ones from Apple, and I'm able to like hide it behind my nightstand and just leave this sitting here, and it looks really nice and sleek, and it gets the job done. Now, this here is $4.99, and I absolutely love that price because it's the same price that you get something from like Five Below or something like that. And the quality is just a tad bit better, which I love. I mean, I've had one from Five Below last maybe for like 2 years, so I'm standing behind this. I'm really excited to use it. I just like getting accessories that work within my color scheme. And last but not least, we have this amazing milk frother. Milk frothers these days are like $20. I don't know, because everyone's like trying to be a barista at home. I understand it. I understand inflation's a thing. But at IKEA, they actually lower the price from $2.99 to $1.99 on this milk frother. This milk frother is amazing. I use it for frothing milk, but I also use it to make mousse. there's a little insight into what we make. We make a dark chocolate mousse with this, and it works super well. You just put some of the IKEA batteries in there, which are also super good, and you are good to go. You don't need to spend $20 on a frother. You just run it under some hot water on high power to clean it, and that's about it. Okay guys, that's it for today's video. Those were 15 products from IKEA under $20 that I absolutely love. All these products make my life easier, and I know that you're gonna love them too. I wanna have a conversation down in the comments. Have you picked up any of these products before? How do you use them to make your life easier? I definitely wanna know. If you liked today's video, please don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and check me out on Instagram. And until next time, have a beautiful day.